Hey, Alice, how you doing, my man?
Nice to see you, Ian.
Everything cool?
Everything's very cool, thank you.
Nice
yeah.
one.
Yeah.
It's really strange because if I once when you're on the radio, I just try to imagine what your face is looking like at that particular time, being an impressionist, always thinking what your face is like.
It does change with the voices. It is quite strange. But also, you start to look like them when you do them. And you
That's
have to.
What I was going
to
say. I remember you when I was to. Younger, watching Mike Yarwood. He yeah. looked like everybody he'd done.
Yeah. Well, you can either make the effort to do it or it just happens. And I never really make the effort, but it just happens. Like, you know, your old mate, Graham Taylor, for instance. You know, if you want to do that voice, you know, to be honest with you, your face has to take on a certain shape to get that sound, you know. So that's... It just sort of happens here. Do you know what I'm saying? It just sort of happens here.
You know the thing as well, we used to laugh, just a quick one before we go into it about the shelter, is that when he used to talk, the longer he would speak for Graham Taylor, a little bit of spittle would just continuously build on that bottom bit of his lip. And like, no matter what he talks about, you just cannot think of anything. What he's saying, you can't compute anything what he's saying, because all you're thinking about is, can you please lick that off your lip? It's putting me off.
You start doing the licking thing yourself, don't you? No one ever gets that. You start doing it.
So, Alistair, tell us about the stand-up for shelter. Who's involved and what's happening?
It's the 27th of February. Mm-hmm. It seems like a long way off, but the Hammersmith Apollo is a big old place.
It's
We've
a
got some tickets
gap.
To shift. And it's all in aid of shelter. So I'm doing a spot, which is pretty rare these days in London.
What do you mean? Why is it rare? Alistair McGowan.
I know.
The voice.
I do, thank you very much. I don't do that many London gigs, so this is a big chance to see me live in London.
Is that
20 minutes to start?
Is that because, for what reason don't you do many London gigs? Is there not a lot of call for your sort of work in London?
Somebody like Stoney, he's doing eight gigs a week. He's doing eight gigs a week, Ian. That's why his voice is always shot to pieces. But no, I'm not doing that sort of eight gigs a week thing anymore. I do because I own like a few corporate events, dare I say it, whisper it quietly. And I do a few out-of-town things, but I'm not really doing that eight gigs a week thing, because I do a lot of stuff like radio and radio plays and theatre stuff and narrations and all that sort of stuff. So it takes up your time. And every so often I have a concerted effort and push the stand-up, but I haven't done it for a while. But I'm going on tour next spring as well, March to May.
Brilliant.
So this will be a great way of sort of...
Before that happens, you come on the show and we talk about it, and then we...
I'll
pump some tickets off you.
Yeah,
that would
be really
nice
good.
One now.
Really good.
Football fan? You're a big football fan?
I'm a big football fan. It's always a huge part of the act.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I've been doing it for nearly 20 years.
Absolutely.
So I've got characters that go back from the days of Graham and obviously Glenn, you know, I know his manager of England when he was part of the setup there.
you know what people got? Glenn, it's the face. You're right.
That's right. And Glenn was always pulling that face like, you know, he was in a cold wind. It was just like, you know, I'm going to turn that air conditioner off. It's a bit strong. So it goes right back to those days, my interest in football. And obviously, whenever I do Steve Wright's show on Radio 2, and I better not say that because you don't want me to talk about
No, man.
Whenever I go on other shows, that they say, oh, do your Trevor Brooking, because that's
Trevor.
One that I did, you know,
you
years
do
ago.
You do look like Trevor Brooking.
Well, it's very, I don't know if it's nice of you to say so. It was always a good one to do. But obviously, you can't keep doing Trevor. You've got to move on. So obviously, now I'm doing the likes of Gareth Southgate, you know, who obviously played alongside you in that, you know, England setup back there in the 90s. And Gareth's a very interesting person to do again. Facially, because obviously he's got such, you know, well, large teeth is the way to describe it. So
big nose as well.
Yeah, but you have to imagine that you've got the large teeth, otherwise the voice doesn't sound quite right. So I have to imagine I've got very large teeth, which I haven't. But yeah, you've got to move on. Go to the new people. And Shearer, of course, you know, and
yes,
always very serious. Alan, no, it's I think that they've really got to look seriously at that, Gary, because you know, this sort of thing's happening more and more, and I don't like it.
It is true. It's
very,
the face.
Absolutely.
It's in the face.
Hardly what, you know, moves.
What
hardly
about.
Moves.
So, in respects of.
Looks like he's a policeman who's about to take a statement.
That's what it is.
Is there anything amusing? Just tell me the facts. That's all I want to know. I've none of your lip, lad. All right?
He could be a policeman. Shocks could be a policeman. So, when you. For instance, like someone like Roy Keane, would you be working on someone like Roy Keane's? How does that work, Alistair? Do you just sit there and watch it, and everybody you see, you go, bang, right, I'll try him up.
Yeah, I do. I have a little go. And sometimes they come quite easily. Southgate, actually, I watched for years and couldn't get him. And then one
day, comes, what was the problem?
Because he sounded like a lot of people, for a start. He actually sounds, he does sound quite like Beckham. And, you know, if you do your Beckham, which, you know, I've been doing for years now, you've got to think, well, what's the difference really between what David does and what Gareth does? And what Gareth does, it's a tiny little change, and it's about those teeth. And I didn't realise that until I was watching him and thinking, of course, you've got to make the shape of the mouth. And that means pretending you've got these large teeth. It's the same with somebody like, I can't go into it straight away. It's the same with someone like John Bishop. You know, he's also got those teeth. And you got the picture that you got the teeth and put your tongue on your teeth and make it sound like you've got a mouth that's a different shape from where you're about to really is. But yeah, Southgate took a long time, and some of them take a long time, and that's why sometimes it comes overnight, and other times 2 or 3 months, which is why it's never worth doing the Chelsea manager, because you think, well, I spent 2 or 3 months doing it, getting it, and then they're gone. So I never bother with Chelsea managers anymore.
Is this
and Roy Keane?
Roy Keane
could not do him. I tried in the summer. I did this show on ITV, and I was doing the likes of Adrian Childs, and,
yes,
you know, all the presenters of the Euros, and having great fun I was with Adrian and Gareth, who I've done to death, so I won't do him anymore. But I wanted to get Roy Keane so I could do the three of them, and I couldn't get him. Absolutely, could not get anywhere near him.